Right. Our next presenter is Shirelle Liu, College of Liberal Arts, Psychology PhD program.
I don't like the feeling of losing control, so I deeply sympathize with over 36 million people in this world who've lost control of their lives to substances. In other words, they suffer from drug addiction. I don't particularly enjoy changes either, especially if they stem from a difficult past and still negatively affect me. I'm afraid that they will just stay with me forever. Unfortunately, this is also another prominent feature of drug addiction. The brain chemistries and activities will change during drug use, and some of them can stay around for up to a lifetime. The consensus is that these changes are the biological signatures of drug use, and they cause persistent problems like high risk of relapse in many, but not all, people with addiction histories. So I definitely feel their pain, and I really want to help. I study opioids using animal models. Opioids are highly addictive, and they are the most dangerous abuse drugs. Importantly, just like people, animals also exhibit a wide range of addiction severity. But the differences in the brains during drug use between those vulnerable and resilient individuals are very poorly understood. So we decided to uncover the brain mechanisms underlying such individual differences. We have three rat models to capture three chronological stages in human addiction. And then we compare the biological changes in the brains between those vulnerable and resilient rats. Remember at the beginning we said that drug use lead to brain changes, and those changes lead to addiction, right? Well, we discovered that that might not be exactly the case. See, our most unexpected and intriguing finding is that across our three models, we see most changes in resilient animals. It naturally begs the question, if all changes lead to addiction, then why do we see more in resilient individuals? Does that mean those changes, albeit associated with drug use, are not necessarily all bad? Our results indicate that changes in resilient animals might be the strategies their brains choose to use to combat addiction. These findings will provide us with a completely new perspective for treating addiction, which is, instead of preventing or reversing changes associated with drug use altogether, we could enhance the ones that lead to resiliency. In my thesis, I'm thoroughly examining these potentially protective adaptations and turn them into our advantage. In the end, this journey reminds me that sometimes surprises and hopes exist where we least expect them, just like we can still find hope even inside the addicted brains. Thank you.